trigonometric function. So let's start with some basic questions on the properties which we have already done. Okay, so I'll just write the question. So you have to find the value of sec square tan inverse x, sorry, sec square tan inverse 2 plus cosec square cot inverse 3. Sec square of tan inverse 2 and cosec square of cot inverse 3 is equals to what? You have to find the value of this. Okay. Anyone has got the answer? Sir, can you make me the host?
Sir, you are already the host.
Oh, okay, yeah, I thought you are the host. Okay, sorry. Okay, let's see. So basically, they have given sec square of tan inverse of 2 and cosec inverse of cot inverse of 3. Fine. So let's solve them individually. So first, we'll solve this part. First, we'll try to solve the first part, which is sec inverse of, sorry, this part, which is sec square of cos inverse of, or tan inverse of 3. Okay. So what we get, so let's write sec square of tan inverse of 2, right? So this can be rewritten as sec. So this basically, this can be rewritten as, because this is only a theta. Yeah, 15 is correct. This is only the angle, right? This will give you the angle. So this will become, simply this will become sec of tan inverse of 2 whole square. Yes, so this will become, yeah, answer is 15, correct. Sec of tan inverse of 2 whole square, right? Now, tan inverse I can write in terms of sec. So again, I will try to form the triangle in which tan inverse of 2, tan inverse of 2 means 2 by 1. That means 2 by 1. So this will become root 5, right? So this is hypotenuse, height and base, right? So for this one, if I will write sec inverse of root 5, and this will be whole square. Right, so this will become, simply become sec of sec inverse of root 5 will be root 5. So this will become simply root 5 whole square, right? So this part is nothing but equals to 5, right? Let's look at the right side, this part also. This is cosec square of cot inverse of 3, right? So this we can write as cosec square of cot inverse of 3 we can write as cosec of cot inverse of 3 whole square, right? Basically, cot inverse of 3 is what? Cot inverse of 3 is, so in this case, again, it will form a triangle. So this, the base will be 3. So the base, so this, again, if we'll try to form a triangle, so the base will be 3 and the height will be 1. So the hypotenuse will be root of 10, right? So this will become cosec inverse of, so cosec will be cosec, if I write cosec of cosec inverse, so cosec of cosec inverse, so this will become root 10 by 1 and this whole square. So this is nothing but root 10 whole square and this is nothing but 10. So this will be 5, this will be 10, so 10 plus 5 will give you 50. Understood? Let's check this one. Fine. This one is okay. Very good. Now, one more thing is that one of you is asking that, son, can we use sec square is equal to the relation between sec square and 10 square? Yes, you can use that also, right? So we will use first solving this, then we will use one more method. So either you can solve using this. This is also very simple, right? And the other one is we have, some of you have tried, might have tried this also. Sec square, you have sec square of 10 inverse of 2 plus you have cosecant square of, you have cot inverse of 3. Now, okay. So, one more thing is that, now we know that sec is related to 10, right? There is an identity, and cosec is related to cot. Again, there is an identity. So, what we can do, we can write this sec square as, so we know that sec square is equals to 1 plus 10 sec square theta is equals to 1 plus 10 square theta. Now this we can treat as theta. This we can treat as theta. So this will simply become 1 plus 10 square of theta, right? And this is 1 plus 10 square of theta is what? 10 inverse of 2, right? So this will become 1 plus 10 square. So this will become 10 inverse of 2 whole square. This is nothing but 1 plus 2 square. This whole thing becomes nothing but equals to 5. So from the previous also we were getting 5. From this way also we are getting 5. Okay. Now again thing, again same thing for cosec square of what square, cos inverse theta, inverse of 3. So this again I can treat as a 5. So this will become cosec square 5 will be equals to 1 plus cot square of 5, right? So this is 5, so this we can write as 1 plus cot 5, so 5 is what, cot inverse of 5, it's cot inverse of, sorry, 3, this becomes whole square, this is nothing but 1 plus 3 whole square, this is nothing but 1 plus 9, so this is nothing but 10. In the previous case also we were getting 10, and here also in the previous case, we are getting 5. So 10 plus 5, again, we are getting 50. Okay. So in both the cases, no matter what you do, you will end up getting same answer. Right. So this one also, this one is also simple. The previous one is also equally simple. Okay. Fine. Let's do one more similar question. Very much similar to this. So find the value of 10 square sec inverse of 2 plus cot square cosec inverse of 3. Okay. Videsh, bacha, this is tan of 10 inverse of 2. Tan of 10 inverse of 2. This will become 2. No, no, this is 10 of 10 inverse of 2. Anirudh, check the sign. Anirudh, check the sign. Yes, this one is very simple. Fine. So now again, either we can solve in the previous method where we form this as a triangle, or we can use the identity. So here if we use the identity, so we have, so this we can write as tan of, if the, we will write this as theta. So this will be nothing but tan of theta whole square. So tan theta whole square is nothing but sec square theta. Sec square theta minus 1. Here theta is sec inverse of 2. So this becomes sec square. So sec square of sec inverse 2 whole square minus 1. Right? So this becomes 4 minus 1. Right? This becomes 4 minus 1. And next we have cot square of cosec. So this will be cot. If I take this as phi. If I take this as phi. So this is cot phi whole square. Right, so this will be again cosec square phi minus 1. If I again substitute, so this will become cosec into cosec inverse of 3 whole square minus 1. Right, so this is 4 minus 1 and this is 9 minus 1. 4 plus 9, 13 minus 2, 11. Simple as that. Okay, so either you can solve in this way. Or suppose instead of tan square and cot square, they have given sine and cos. So you can simply turn into a triangle and then you can find the answer. Fine? Okay, I have this kind of question. Is clear? Fine? Very good. Okay, let's do one more. Fine, so the question is, the value of the value of tan inverse of sine cos inverse of tan inverse of sine cos inverse of root 2. Yes, 5 or 6 is correct. Very good. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Yes, 5 or 6 is correct. Okay, so let's solve this one also. This is very simple. So what we have been given tan inverse of sine of cos inverse, right? So first thing which we can see that inside the bracket we have this part. Inside the bracket we have this part. So what we can try to solve this part first, right? So this is simply sine of cos inverse of root 2 by root 3. Sine of cos inverse of root 2 by root 3, right? So basically, we can form this as a triangle. If this is a triangle, then we can write this as simply as root 2. So root 3 will be hypotenuse and root 2 will be the base. Root 3 will be the hypotenuse and root 2 will be the base. So we can find height, right? So this is simply, so this height will become 1 because root 3 square minus root 2 square is under root. So this will become 1. So basically, if we try to find out the sine inverse of something, so this will become sine of sine inverse of 1 by root 3. Sine of sine inverse of 1 by root 3. So this will simply come out to be 1 by root 3. Very good. So this is basically, this value is nothing but 1 by root 3. If this is 1 by root 3, I will take tan inverse. So this is tan inverse of 1 by root 3. In principal value, for tan inverse, the principal value is nothing but pi by 6. So answer is pi by 6. है ना. अरे बच्चे देखो, forget about this tan inverse first. Forget about this tan inverse first. First we'll use this. So this is sine of cos inverse. I will try to find out the value of this, right? What is the value of this? So this is sine of cos inverse of root 2 by 3. I will form a triangle. I will take this as an angle phi. Right? So this is an angle phi. So I will form a triangle. This is base. Numerator will be base and denominator will be the hypotenuse. Right? So this will become, height will become 1. A square minus B square. Means C square minus B square or A square, anything you want. So this will become 1. So now I will try to find the angle. So this will be sine inverse of phi. So sine inverse of phi, basically I have to find the phi, right? So in terms of sine, it will be height upon hypotenuse. Yes? But your identity we can only form if we have squares. Hai na? बच्चे वो स्क्वायर, इफ देयर इज अ स्क्वायर बट देयर इज नो स्क्वायर, वी कैन ओनली यूज आइडेंटिटी इफ देयर इज अ स्क्वायर बट हियर देयर इज नो स्क्वायर. इन द प्रीवियस केस, इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस वी हैड स्क्वायर्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस वी ऑलरेडी हैड दीज स्क्वायर्स गिवन टू अस बट हियर वी डू नॉट हैव एनी स्क्वायर, दैट इज आई एम नॉट यूजिंग आइडेंटिटी. है ना? ओके फाइन. नेक्स्ट वन. सो दिस इज this question is 2005 JEE advanced. Okay. Yeah, if you use the identity and you write in the proper principal angles, you will get the same answer. If your procedure is correct, then the answer should be C. Even if you use identity also, right? Okay, so this was JEE advanced 2015. Okay. I'll write the question. Let's solve it very carefully. Okay, a very simple question. So they have given that alpha is equals to 3 of sine inverse of 6 by 11. Okay, and beta is equals to 3 times of cos inverse of 4 by 9. Okay. Alpha is equals to sine inverse of this and beta is equals to cos inverse of this. Okay. Then, and they have given that sine inverse will take only principal values. So, they have given first thing, option A, cos of beta is greater than 0. Second is sine of beta is less than 0. Third is cos of alpha plus beta is greater than 0, and the option D is cos of alpha is less than 0. Yes. Find the answer. Okay, this was JEE advanced 4 marks question, multiple choice. Okay, multiple choice. So please take your time, try to solve the question. Take your time, don't worry if it take 2 or 3 minutes. We can give 2 or 3 minutes to our JEE advanced question. Just take your time and solve the question. बच्चे दैट आई विल कंफर्म विद सर है ना इफ देयर इज बाइनरी ऑपरेशन और नॉट बिकॉज आई एम नॉट मेकिंग द एनसीईआरटी पेपर अदर सर इज सो आई विल चेक द आई टेल यू विद हिम एंड आई विल जस्ट टेल यू गाइस दैट इफ देयर इज बाइनरी ऑपरेशन और नॉट ओके It's a multiple choice question, so more than one is correct. I'm telling you that more than one is correct, है ना? Tell me which options are correct. Solve very carefully. Okay, 1 and 4, fine. Should I solve? Should I start solving? Okay, see. You can try to be second and four. Okay, fine. So let's see. So basically, the problem with multiple choice questions are fine. Okay, so let's start solving. So the thing is that problem with multiple choice questions are that even if you get, suppose somebody is getting B and D, right? Somebody is getting B and D, and suppose C was also correct, then the answer would be wrong. Answer would be considered wrong. So basically, you have to find every correct answer, every correct alternative within the given four options, and you have to mark them, right? It is not as simple as single correct, because in single correct means if there is no multiple choice, multiple correct answers. Then you know which, if only one you have got the correct answer, you will mark it, right? So in this case, B, C, and D are correct. B, C, and D were the correct options. Correct options, right? Now see, let's start solving. So basically, the first thing that we can see in the options, they have taken only the range. They have taken considered the only the sign of cos alpha, cos beta, cos alpha plus beta, right? In the option, they have only considered the sign. That means we are not, the first thing we'll observe is we are not bothered about exact values. We are not bothered about the exact value. First thing, you don't even have to worry about the exact value. And one more thing, by sine inverse of 6/11, who can find in paper? Nobody can. It's the cos inverse of 4 and 4/9. Nobody can find. So definitely they only want you to find the range of alpha and range of beta. That is it. They just want you to find the range of alpha and beta. Okay. So let's try to find out the ranges of alpha and beta. Now to find the range of alpha and beta, alpha is dependent on sine inverse this thing, and beta is dependent of cos inverse of this thing, right? So to find the range of alpha, ultimately I have to, the question converts to finding the ranges of, so ultimately the question converts to finding the range of sine inverse of 6/11 and cos inverse of 4 by 9. Sin inverse of 6 by 11 and cos inverse of 4 by 9. Right? Also, one more thing that if we'll observe them very closely, this 6 by 11 is also less than 1 and 4 by 9 is also less than 1. 6 by 11 is also less than 1 and 4 by 9 is also less than 1. That means we should get a principal value. That means we should get a principal value, approximate principal value, right? Now, 6 by 11. So, sine inverse of 6 by 11 and cos inverse of 4 by 11. Sine inverse of 6 by 11 and we have cos inverse of 4 by 9. Sine inverse of 6 by 11 and cos inverse of 4 by 9. Right. Now, in order to find the range, so this will give you some angle, suppose theta, and this will give you some angle, suppose phi. Now, in order to find the range of theta, you have to find 6 by 11 is in what range? 6 by 11 is greater than or less than what number, right? So, 6 by 11, so if this was 6 by 12, this would have simply become 1 by 2. If this was 6 by 12, this would have simply become 1 by 2. So, that means 6 by 11 is less than 1 by 2. 6 by 11 is definitely less than 1 by 2. But this one is definitely greater than, 6 by 11, sorry, is, if this was 12, this would have become 1 by 2, right? But 6 by 11 is definitely greater than 1 by 2, right? And definitely greater than 1 by 2. And this is definitely lesser than root 3 by 2. This is definitely lesser than root 3 by 2. So why am I writing in this form? Because now I have a lower limit of phi. I have lower limit of theta and upper limit of theta. So if this is sine inverse of 6 by 11 will always be greater than sine inverse of 1 by 2 and less than sine inverse of root 3 by 2. And right? So this sine inverse of 6 by 11 is always greater than what? Pi by 6, right? And always less than what? Pi by 3. This everybody understood? So this thing is always less than pi by 3 and greater than pi by 6. Okay? Now again, if I multiply this with 3, because what do I have? Alpha is 3. 3 into this thing. So if I simply multiply this with 3, so I have to multiply 3 on both the sides. So this will be 3 sine inverse of 6 by 11 will be less than pi by 3 into 3. So this is 3 into pi by 3. So this 3 and 3 gets cancelled. And on the left side also will be greater than pi by 6 into 3. So this and this gets cancelled. This will cancel with 2. So that means, and this is nothing but alpha. So basically, what is the range of alpha? So alpha is less than pi by 3. Right? Alpha is less than pi and greater than pi by 2. Okay? Alpha is less than pi and greater than pi by 2. Okay? Fine? So what we have done? We know that value of 6 by 11 will be something greater than 0.5. 6 by 11 will be something greater than 0.5, right? So what we are having that this thing 6 by 11 will be greater than 1 by 2 and will be less than root 3 by 2. Bache, 1 by root 2, see, because 1 by root 2, bache, dekho, kya hai ki, haan pe, we have 3 multiplied. We have multiplied with 3. Understood? Hai na? Also, if you take 1 by root 2, this value will, you will not be able to get the range in which. Hai na? So also one, two things. One, we have 3. Though that is why I have taken these two values, because pi by 3 and pi by 6, they will simply get cancelled, right? and we will get a good range in this. And understood? Fine. So this is what we are having, the range. Fine. Just check this one first. Okay. Now I want you to do something similar with cos inverse of 4 by 6 also. I want you to do something similar with cos inverse of 4 by 9 also. Okay. Fine, this one everybody understood. We could have used 1 by root 2 also. We could have used 1 by root 2 also. Even then you will get the same answer which we want. But here, why am I using root 3 by 2? Because I have 3 multiplied, right? I have 3 multiplied. Okay, very good. Srivatsan, pi beta is greater than pi. And yes, very good. Excellent. Anna? So now again, so this was for alpha, right? I will try to find the similar thing was beta. Okay. Okay. So let's see. So we had phi is equals to cos inverse of 4 by 9. Okay. Now again, I will write. So because I know that phi will be multiplied with 3. Phi will be multiplied with 3, right? So let's see. So basically, cos inverse of 4 by 9. So this is 4 by 9. If this was 4 by 8, this would be 1, right? So that means 4 by 9 is greater than, so 4 by 9. So we know the cos inverse of 4 by 9, this would be greater than cos inverse of 1 by 2. Cos inverse of 1 by 2. And this will be less than cos inverse of 0. Yes, just check this one. Right, let's see how we can write this one. Fine. So these from here, this is 1, this is minus 1, this is cos inverse curve. Yes, cos inverse curve decreasing, right? Yes, correct. Right? So we have 4 by 9 suppose somewhere here. We have 4 by 9 suppose somewhere here, right? So more value. So 4 by 9, so more value will be above and less value will be below. So suppose this is more value will be cos inverse of 2, right? And this value here will be 1 by 2 will be somewhere here, and 1 by 2 will be somewhere here, and 0 will be here. Understood? Now, also, if you do not remember this cos inverse, so we can draw this function also, right? So, suppose we have to find the value of phi. So, cos of phi, you can think about it as cos of phi is equals to 4 by 9, right? So, 4 by 9 will be something less than half. So suppose half is, so this is 1, so half is somewhere here, right? So if I take half value, so suppose this is half, so this will be some angle, right? This is that angle for half. Now 4 by 9 is less than, so it will be somewhere here, right? And cos inverse 0 will be somewhere here. So between these two values, you will get. Understood? Between these two values, you will get somewhere near. Here you will get as 4 by 9. I hope everybody understood. So that is why I have written this equation. Just check this one. Everybody understood this one? Just tell me, everybody understood this relation or not? Everyone? Yes? See, 4 by 9 is less than 1 by 2. Hai na? Subhiksha, so 4 by 9 is less than 1 by 2. Right? But the thing is that 4 by 9, this is cos, this is value 1, maximum value is 1, and minimum value is 0. Right? Minimum value is 0. Suppose 1 by 2 is somewhere here. Right? 1 by 2 is somewhere here. So you'll get 1 by 2 here. Now, where will be 4 by 9? Between 0 and 1 by 2. So this will be value 4 by 9. Right? So this will give you the value of 5. This will give you 5. So 5 will be between what? 5 will be between this angle as well as this angle. What is this? This angle is pi. And what is this? This angle is 1 by 2 is what? Cos inverse of 1 by 2 is what? Pi by 3. Understood? So this one is pi by 3 and this is pi. Pi by 3 and pi by 2. Understood? So now you understood, na? So basically, what we... So here I will write. So cos inverse of 4 by 9, cos inverse of 4 by 9 is greater than cos inverse of 1 by 2 is what? Pi by 2 and less than, and this is, sorry, cos inverse of 1 by 2 is pi by 3 and this is less than pi by 2, right? So now what we have to find actually, we have to find the value of 3 cos inverse of 4 by 9, 3 into cos inverse of 4 by 9. So if we'll simply multiply this with 3 in all the sides, so this will become cos inverse of 4 by 9 into 3 is less than 3 pi by 2 and greater than 5. So this is less than 3 pi by 2 and greater than 5. Okay. So I will write both the results on the same page now. I will write both the results on the same page now. Okay. So we have this. So this is basically, this is beta. So alpha is greater than pi by 2 and less than pi. And we have 3 cos inverse. Beta is greater than pi and beta is greater than pi and less than 3 pi. So I can write this as beta is greater than pi and less than 3 pi. So I got these two ranges of alpha and beta, right? I got just these two ranges of alpha and beta, and see, they have not used any complex trigonometric, inverse trigonometric formula or anything. They have not used any complex formula. They have simply used the domain and range. They have simply used the property of cos. And they have simply multiplied with 3 so that you will get a better boundary of alpha. Again, better boundaries of alpha, right? So now alpha is in, second quadrant. And beta is in greater than pi is in third quadrant, right? So let's see, look at the option once again, right? Let's look at the option once again. So cos beta is greater than 0. Cos beta is greater than 0, okay? So now in third quadrant, cos beta cannot be greater than 0 because in third quadrant, cos beta is negative. So first thing is that first option is wrong. First option is wrong, okay? Now, sine beta... third quadrant, so I will just write here third and I will write here second. Sine beta is in third quadrant. Sine of beta in third quadrant should be negative. So this one is correct. Right? So option B is correct. Option B is correct. Third. Let's see options. First we'll observe option D. So option D. Both in second and third quadrant, cos will be negative. Both in second and third quadrant, cos will be negative, right? So the option D is also correct. So option D is also correct. Now the last option remain is cos alpha plus beta. They have given cos of alpha plus beta. They have given greater than 0. So we will simply add alpha and beta. So simply adding alpha and beta. So alpha plus beta. So pi by 2 plus pi. Pi by 2 plus pi will be always greater than pi by 2 plus pi. Pi by 2 plus pi. And always be less than. I'll always be less than pi plus 3 pi by 2. Okay. So that means alpha plus beta will always be greater than 3 pi by 2. Okay. And will be less than 5 pi by 2. Understood? 3 pi by 2 means, this means what? This means in, so 3 pi by 2, 270, and 5 pi by 2, again, this, so basically this becomes, if, so this becomes into two quadrants. First is fourth one and first, right? In both fourth and first, cos is positive. So in both fourth and first, cos is positive. So that means this one is correct. So that means C is also correct. So B, C, and D are the correct things. Enough? Understood? Fine. Everybody understood? So just check this one. I think this one was the only part which was tricky. Okay, one more thing. Even here, if somebody is doubting that, even here, if I take 1 by root 2, even if here, if I take 1 by root 2, even then you would have got the same answer. Even if you had taken 1 by root 2, even then you would have got the same answer. Understood? It would have given you a more constrained part of alpha and beta. Everybody understood? Right? Is there any part in the question which I should explain once again? Just tell me, I will explain once again. Everyone understood? Are bacha, yes or no? If you understood, then just tell me, then I'll move forward. Yes? Very good, very good, very good. Okay. So now, let's do one more question. Just wait. Fine. Okay. Fine. This is simpler one. So let's see. So find the principal value of cos inverse of minus of sine of 7 pi by 6. Cos inverse of minus of 7 pi by 6. A very simple question. And if you have done this, because this is very simple, so after this, just solve this one. 10 inverse of x plus 2 cot inverse of x is equals to 2 pi by 3, then find x. Find x. Pi by 3 for this one? Very good. Correct. Pi by 3 is correct answer. Okay. If you've got this one, solve for this. Yes. Very good. Pi by 3 is correct. Very good. If you solve this one, try to find this one. Nahi bacha, 1 by root 3 b. No, no, no. Just check the root 3 you will get, but not 1 by root 3. You will get only root 3. Just check the calculation. Yes, root 3 is correct. Enough? Root 3 you are getting? Yes, very good. Fine. So simply, first I will solve this one. A very simple question. So this is nothing but. Okay. So this is cos inverse of minus of this. You don't have to do anything with this. You simply find the value. It will always be, the value will always be between minus 1 to 1. Right? So this will be simply minus of sine of, this can simply be written as sine of pi plus pi by 6. This thing can be written, so this will be cos inverse of minus of, this will be cos inverse of minus of minus sine of pi by 6. So this will become cos inverse of sine pi by 6, right? And we either we can convert this into sine or cos, anything you want. So the answer you will get as pi by 3. Fine. Okay. The next one is, yeah, this. If I solve this one, so tan inverse of x plus 2 cot inverse of x, right? So now we have tan inverse and tan. Here we have cot inverse, but we know we can convert tan into cot. So this is tan inverse of x plus 2 into cot inverse or tan inverse. What is the relation? It will be simply pi by 2 minus tan inverse of x, and this is tan inverse of x minus 2 tan inverse of x plus pi is equals to 2 pi by 3. If I'll bring this here, so this is pi minus 2 pi by 3 is equals to, you will have tan inverse of x. So this is tan inverse of x is equals to, this will become pi by 3. Tan inverse of x pi by 3 means x is equals to 3. Fine. Two very simple questions. Okay. Fine. So till here, I hope everything is clear. Okay. So now we will move on to one more property. One more property. So I will just simply write down the property. However, for your CBSE perspective, I don't think so the property is required. But even then, it is better if you know the property. You know? For CBSE, I don't think so it is required. But for JEE perspective, you should know the property. You know? At least you should have seen somewhere. Okay. So the property will be given as, so first is, so this is basically, you can call this sub addition and subtraction of our angles. You know? So first is in tan. So you'll have tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equals to, fine, tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equals to tan inverse of xy by 1 minus xy if x and y are less than 1. Okay. Second is pi plus tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy if x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0, and xy are greater than 0. And the third is minus pi plus tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy if x is less than 0, y is less than 0, and xy is greater than 0. Okay, just copy this. Oh, sorry, this is x plus y. Tan inverse of x plus y. You know, tan inverse of x plus y, 1 minus x plus y. Yeah, just copy this thing. Saran bachche, if two negative values are multiplied, then they will always become positive. Hai na? Okay. So just look at them once. Hai na? If you remember the first part, you should remember. Okay. The first part you should remember. If you remember the first part, then just first two. Remember the first two parts. Okay. If you remember the first two part, the third part you can already, it will be memorized. Right? For now, I will write for this one also. Almost similar, just few changes. Tan inverse of x minus y upon 1 plus xy if xy is greater than minus 1. Second is pi plus tan inverse of x minus y upon 1 plus xy. If x is greater than 0, y is less than 0, and xy is less than minus 1. And third one is minus pi plus tan inverse of x minus y upon 1 plus xy. If x less than 0, y greater than 0, and xy less than minus 1. Just write them once. Just write these property after the class also. Just write these properties two times. Just once you have written, just write one more time and then just leave them. You don't have to memorize them also. Just try to memorize the first part of both of them. But a proof is not that difficult. Proof is very simple. If you have some book, you can just check in the book also proof. However, the proof is not required. The proof is very simple actually. And I just take two angles. Just take two angles, right? And then try to find out the range of that two angles. Okay, it is in NCERT. I can check the proof. If you are not getting the proof, I can explain. See, I will explain the first part, how you can do. First, you just write them once. The test, bacha, your NCERT test, your CBSE test, your school test will be completely fully based on NCERT only. Nothing will be asked outside from NCERT. If something which I have done which are outside, so it will not come. Fine. But if it is from inside, then it will come. Inside, even miscellaneous question, everything will be asked. Right. So I will just explain how you can get the proof. It is very simple. See, tan inverse x and tan inverse y. Suppose if I'm not sure, bacha, for test, I'm not sure. But I'm only sure about the syllabus. But how the test will be conducted, will it be online or offline? I think 100% it has to be online, because offline tests, I don't think so we can conduct. So it will be online test. But I'm not sure how online test. Maybe they will give you a time and then you have to solve and something. Okay. Maybe they will figure out something. Okay, bacha. Fine. So basically what they have done, so I will tell you the procedure in which you can get this. Okay, maybe you have to send the photo or something. Maybe that is a fact. So what you will do, you will take this as angle phi and you will take this as angle theta, right? You can take this as angle phi, you can take this as angle theta. Okay. Now also we know that range of phi is what? Range of phi is what? And range of theta is what? Right? So range of phi from 0 to pi by 2, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and range of phi is also from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Right? So this is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and this is also minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Right? Now if we'll add these two, what will be the combined range? What will be the combined range? So this will become phi plus theta. If we'll add these two, this the combined range will be phi plus theta. So this will become the maximum value of this will become less than phi, and the minimum value this will become greater than minus pi by 2. Fine. So if this is the case, if we have got this thing, minus pi by 2, this, right? Now see, if we are trying to find out, we know that this part will be equal to this part, this tan inverse of x, and because we know that tan x plus y upon 1 minus x y will be tan of phi plus theta, right? We know this part will be equal to this thing, right? But the thing is that because this is less than phi and greater than less than pi and greater than minus pi, you will have some changes in the curve because tan of tan inverse something will be different, right? So you can use that concept. Understood? So you can use that concept because tan inverse of tan x is function something like this, right? So this is y is equals to x. This will be y is equals to x when we have x and y less than 1. And when we have x and y less than 1, this will be in this range. So no matter what you have, phi plus theta, you will get simply this. But in this part, what you are having, this is y is equals to minus x minus pi. Sorry, minus x plus pi. This line and this line is nothing but y is equals to minus x minus pi. Right? So from, can you see? Now, whatever x you will substitute, you will get something here, and whatever x you will substitute, you will get something. Okay? So just हाँ बच्चा only properties are left, properties and based questions on them, है ना? So just look at these formulas, write them once or twice, just believe me, write them once or twice, and if you want to check the proof, you can check the proof from NCERT books if it is given. I don't think so it is given, but I have not checked. But if it is given, if you are not comfortable, then I will teach. Don't worry. Okay, fine. That's all for today. I will show you this the notes once again. Just take the